Is Michelle Obama to become the new face of Victoria's Secret? No, that's not true. The story was published by a liberal satire website that tries to mislead Trump supporters and Republicans into sharing made-up stories that are clearly marked as satire when you actually click them. Articles from the site are frequently copied by foreign-run fake news websites. The people liking and sharing these stories are enriching foreign website operators or a liberal from Maine via the ad revenue generated with the content, which is probably not what they expected or wanted. The story originated from an article published by Obama Watcher on October 16, 2019 titled Michelle Obama to be new face of Victoria's Secret, which opened, quote, "In the world of women's fashion, Victoria's Secret is a juggernaut. Earning billions last year from their mail order and internet sales, along with their successful retail store franchises, it's a company that constantly dominates the Fortune 500. And now, First Lady Michelle Obama will be the public face of that institution. In a contract rumored to net her upwards of $11.3 million a year, the best-selling author will be featured in print, television, and Facebook advertisements, as well as live chats and meet and greets at various outlets. Company spokesperson Mona Roundick explained why Obama was the top choice. She's powerful, successful, strong, intelligent and sexy, everything we want Victoria's Secret to represent. Except urging kids to eat broccoli. We're just gonna keep that part on the down low. The campaign is gonna be massive, and we certainly hope that conservatives, who think it's a funny joke to pretend she's transgender, will see it everywhere and tear off their own penises," end quote. Users on social media only saw this title, description and thumbnail. Quote, Michelle Obama to be new face of Victoria's Secret. In the world of women's fashion, Victoria's Secret is a juggernaut. Earning billions last year from their mail order and internet sales, along with their successful retail store Frank. End quote. The story was posted in the category, Michelle Obama fan fiction, and the site is plastered with satire warnings and disclaimers. Anyone with two brain cells who reads the article quickly notices the story as one big joke. That hasn't stopped several foreign-run fake news sites from copying it though, hoping to catch some advertising dollars by reposting it into various conservative groups and pages on Facebook. The site is part of the America's Last Line of Defense network of satire websites run by self-professed liberal troll Christopher Blair from Maine, along with a loose confederation of friends and allies. Blair has been in a feud with fact-checking website Snopes for some time now and has also criticized other fact-checkers in the past who labeled his work fake news instead of satire. In reaction to this, he has recently rebranded all his active websites and Facebook pages so they carry extremely visible disclaimers everywhere. Every site in the network has an about page that reads, in part, quote, about satire before you complain and decide satire is synonymous with comedy. Satire sati, are noun the use of humor, irony, exaggeration, or ridicule to expose and criticize people's stupidity or vices, particularly in the context of contemporary politics and other topical issues. Everything on this website is fiction. It is not a lie and it is not fake news because it is not real. If you believe that it is real, you should have your head examined. Any similarities between this site's pure fantasy and actual people, places, and events are purely coincidental, and all images should be considered altered and satirical. See above if you're still having an issue with that satire thing. End quote. Articles from Blair's sites frequently get copied by real fake news sites who often omit the satire disclaimer and any other hints the stories are fake. Blair has tried to get these sites shut down in the past, but new ones keep cropping up. Here is a video of Blair explaining how his process works. If you are interested in learning more about Blair and the history of his sites, here is something to get you started. Quote, the ultimate Christopher Blair and America's Last Line of Defense Reading List, Lead Stories Story Updated, check for updates below. Yesterday Eli Saslow at The Washington Post wrote a fantastic article about Christopher Blair, a man from Maine who has been trolling conservatives and Trump supporters online for years and occasionally even made a living out of it. End quote. If you see one of his stories on a site that does not contain a satire disclaimer, assume it is fake news. If you do see the satire disclaimer, it is of course also fake news.